Hey guys, this is Mike Tarallo with Qlik. Did you ever wonder how those Qlik visualization gurus create these neat floating collapsible filter panels? Stay tuned to learn more on this episode of Do More with Qlik Tips and Tricks. So let's jump right into this. Here's the example we're going to create. Basically, we have a layout container that has two charts and a button. When we click this button, it's going to switch from the charts to the filters. And as you guessed it, we're using a combination of variables and show hide filters for our objects. Let me go into edit mode. First thing for reference, I'm going to go into my variables. And you can see we have a variable here, V show hide filter. And here I have it set to 0 by default. You don't have to set a default value if you don't want to. Similar to the previous example with the buttons, you can see I had V selected status as well set up. So now that you know we have our variable set up, we're going to grab our layout container, which is in custom objects underneath Qlik dashboard bundle. And I'm just going to position it accordingly. It doesn't have to be exactly perfect. And the first thing I like to do is always set up the visualization options within the container, such as in general, turning off titles, unchecking show hover menu, and then we're going to set a background styling. If I go to styling, we can set up titles and fonts, background colors, images, borders, corner radius, and shadow. You can see I can easily select the background color. We're going to make this background color dynamic with an expression. And in the expression editor, I'm just going to use a very simple logic if statement. Looking at the variable vShowHideFilter, if it's equal to 0, set it to like a dark gray, else set it to like a whitish color. Click apply, and you can see that our layout container is now dark gray because that value has already been set within the variable's default value as 0. Next, we're going to add a button. So I'm just going to search for the standard button chart object, add that button. Now, quick tip, when you edit properties of an object, make sure that the panel is displaying those properties. If not, always right-click on your object, edit properties, and you can see now the button properties are being edited. So similar to like I did before, uncheck show titles. In this case, we are going to show the label, but we're just going to make it blank. And the reason for that is we're going to turn on an icon. So underneath this tab area, we have icon, and you can choose from a variety of different icons. Here, the icon we want is going to be the menu icon. And we can set the position and all that if we want, but right now we're pretty good. So now I'm going to select the object and size it accordingly. And I'm going to put it in the upper left corner, just like that. Okay, so the next thing we want to do is set up actions for this button. So note, when you move the object like you have, it automatically defaults back to the layout container properties. So I got to right click, edit properties, and then you'll see there's a section actions and navigation. And we're going to add an action. You can give an action a label if you want, but you don't need to. And then the action we want to do is to set a variable. So we scroll down, you can see set variable value. It'll give you a list of variables. We're going to do vShowHideFilter. And we're going to set value to 1. And that's all you need to do. So now the next thing we're going to do is we're going to take this button and I'm going to right click on it and select duplicate. And then I'll just position it a little lower so you can see some of the changes take effect, but we're going to basically change some of the options on this button. Right click, edit properties. We're going to change the actions and navigation here to 0. And then under appearance, the icon, we're going to change to a close icon. And then under styling, under chart, we're going to change the background color to like a reddish color. And we're going to basically position this right on top of this button, but I do want to show you something. When you right click and you select edit properties, you're in the properties of the button. But when you click on the button, you're in the properties of the button as the layout structure. So you can see under content in the layout container, you can see how it's highlighted here. And you can see there's position properties and width properties. So these can be manually adjusted. as I position, you'll see that these properties will change depending on which button. So here we have the close button. So here I'll give that a name just to keep them distinct. That's the close button. And then here is the menu button. We'll call it the filter button if you want. And we're going to change these show conditions momentarily. But if you line it up, it'll snap into place, and now you have these two buttons. And then you can access the properties of those buttons using the properties panel within the layout. So these are the objects within the layout under content. Okay, so now we're going to set the states for the button. So for close, we're going to access the show condition, and we're going to put in vShowHideFilter equals 1. Okay, if you want to see what it looks like here. And now you can see, since it's equal to 1 now, it disappeared. And then we're going to go to the filter button. You can call this filter button open if you'd like. And we're going to paste in showHideFilter equal 0. Now watch what happens when we go in here. You can see now we have a switch between the panels and the buttons. So all we need to do now is add our content in the form of charts and filters. So to make things easier, I already have charts added to the master visualizations library. So here's our sales bar chart. Just position accordingly. And I also have the gauge object. Oh, nope, that's different. Let's add it under the master items. Sales gauge, there it is. So remember, the show condition is going to match these charts just like the button, right? So we're showing the button when it's 0. So we're going to show these charts when they are 0. So when you select the chart object, as I stated earlier, you can see there is the content and then the show hide condition for that content. So we're just going to paste vShowHideFilter equals 0 for the sales bar. And we're going to do the same thing for the gauge. So now watch what happens. I click on the button and we go to the other panel. So a little trick here is that the edit mode will respect whatever show hide condition is active at the time. So if I go back here and I click edit sheet, I'm editing that particular layout with the hide condition set for visible. If I go back into analysis mode and I click the button, and now we're in where the filter panel is displayed and the charts are hidden. If I go back into edit mode, it's going to stay like that. This is just a nice little way so you can now add in your filter objects easily. Again, another way to do it would just make sure you select the panel and then just add your objects this way and they'll still be visible. But here I can now lay them out. So now we're going to add a filter pane, and I'm just going to select filter pane and add a dimension. And then we'll just select, you know, our order status, for example, and then position accordingly. If I want to add a date picker, size that accordingly, and then right click, edit properties, go into the date picker, field, select value, order date, appearance, turn off show titles, uncheck hover menu, and then we'll add one more. And I'll do this for product name. Okay, and we're not done yet because we have to just quickly change these show hide conditions. All right, so with each object selected, here's the filter pane. Now you could label these so you know which one is which, but just to keep things easier, in the show condition box, vShowHideFilter equals 1. That is going to be the same for each of the filter objects. And there we go. So right now we're looking at our filter pane. I click the close button. And now we're looking at our charts. Click on the menu button. And now we're looking at our filters. And that's how you create a floating or collapsible filter pane within your Qlik Sense app. This is another great tip that you can use for the after hours visualization session that is going to be held at Qlik Connect on Tuesday from 6:45 p.m. to 9 p.m. It's about 2 hours and 15 minutes. It's going to be listed as the After Hours Pizza and Visualization Workshop, Ready, Steady, and Dash. So you will have to be registered for Qlik Connect, and I believe there is a maximum limit of 100 people. So once you're registered and you have access to the breakout session registration, please do so. All right, guys, I hope this was helpful. Take care. Have a great rest of your day. And I will see you on the next episode of Do More with Qlik Tips and Tricks.